for Nat. You had two bullets left in the gun. You got both still. You guys go past Liberty with a win by JT Brown. First off, JT Brown was emotional, and that guy wanted a state title bad. It gets you guys into the runner-up finish. You're not going to pass St. Ed's. What's it feel like? What are you saying to your guys?
I'm so pumped when our kids win, when they have success. It just makes me so happy as a coach, as a dude. These guys work so hard, man, and for them to get that individual success is huge. You know, if it helps the team, that's awesome. To see what they go through every day, all year long, and to have it come to fruition for them, man, I just love it. I don't know if there's a better feeling in coaching.
Knowing how Mickey wrestled, Mickey, you know, that's hard, man. I was sitting next to you filming, and that's hard being a dad and a coach. Is that the hardest thing you've ever done?
No, man. I love it. I love it. You know, my kid, you know, he makes me proud every time. We step in the wrestling room. Every time we go running together, every time, whatever we do together, he makes me proud. And he wanted to win. He wanted to do better than sixth place down here. And we learned some valuable lessons down here. Even as a father-son combination, we learned some things. And we take that stuff we learn and we go with it. It's only going to help improve him. So I couldn't be more proud of my kid.
Knowing how your team performed, there was some adversity there, and first off, this guy, in talking to your, I think it's your 120-pounder, won state title again, right?
Yeah, Brendan.
Okay, Fenton has Jay Jagger's blood. What do you do? This guy, at one point in the season, he was 500, Coach. Yeah. The guy was 500, and he comes back and wins the title. How do you manage that? How do you train that? How do you do that as a coach? How does that kid do it? He's a two-time state champ.
Yeah. You tell him all the time how good he is. You know what I mean? And Brendan, last year he started believing in himself. And, of course, things came through for him here at the end. This year he went through some rough times, man. He had a late start. He's a good football player. He started late. He wasn't in great shape. Then he got hurt. Then he got hurt again. You know what I mean? It's like there's all these things that can crush you down and can make you question yourself. Brendan may have done that to him a little bit this year, but then he just pulled himself up out of it and he's like, I can do this. I'm good.
Price in the finals. I'm totally shocked. It surprises me. Were you surprised?
No. Brendan Price, he's got ice running through his veins, man. That dude, he'll wrestle anybody. He doesn't care. He just wants to be out there wrestling. He wants to wrestle the best, and he wanted to be in that situation right there. He went after it. And Nicky Cuse has wrestled as well as I've ever seen him wrestle in that match. So credit to him. Wow, he looked good.
Looking at some of the other guys up in that lineup, Breeding finally gets on the podium for you. Does that feel good?
Yeah, I'm really pumped for Josh because it seemed like he had the confidence in himself a couple of these matches here where he's like, hey, man, I'm going to get it done, and he found a way to get it done. It's huge for Josh.
The Master Blaster's coming up. Kevin Vo, how do you get Kevin ready for this match to win a second state title?
Hey, all you do with Kevin is you say, hey, there's this. Go do your best. Have fun. And Kevin, he kind of takes care of things. So hopefully we prepare him as well as what the coach can do. Shauver's a wrestling athlete, and he loves the sport, and he loves to compete. He'll want to go somewhere next week. He wants to go compete. He'll want to go somewhere Wednesday. Hey, coach, is there a tournament Wednesday? I mean, that kid just wants to compete. He loves it.
You got a guy coming up, coach. You got anything else for me?
That's it, Zeb. I appreciate everything else.
Congratulations, coach.